Good morning, students. Dear students, in your previous class, we had discussed about of your exercise 8B and we had solved at the question number 6. Now, in this class, we will solve the rest of the question from the exercise 8B. Now, we start from the question number 7. If 36, 54 and x are in the question number 7, 36, 54 and x are in continuous equation. In continuous equation, then find the value of x. Find the value of x. You know, three quantities are in the continuous proportion. Three quantities, A, B, and C, in continuous when A ratio B such that B ratio C. So, yes, it is in the continuous when then 36 ratio 54. As well as same ratio 54 ratio x. Now we know that the product of extreme is equal to product of mean. Now the product of extreme that is 36 into x is equal to 54 into 54. Now we find the value of x is equal to 54 into 54 upon 36. 4 9 is 36, 9 4 is and 9 6 is. Now 2, 3 and 27. Now we get that is 3 7 21, 3 2 6 and 2 18. Hence value of x is equal to 81. Okay, you note it. Now, next question. That is question number 8. That is as well as same. We will do that. Now we come on the question number 9. Find the third proportional to. Yeah, first and second. First is given 8, 2 and 12. Right? Here it is also continuous proportion. In which in the continuous proportion you know that the third proportion is C. C is the third proportional. If A, B and C are continuous proportion then C is called third proportion
A ratio B such that B ratio C. In this case, in the given question, let third proportion be, let third proportional be x, then A ratio 12 shall that 12 ratio x.
By according to this rule, if A, B, C are a continuous proportion, then C is called the third proportion. Here we suppose that x is the third proportion, then 8 ratio 12 such that 12 ratio x. Now by the extreme product of extreme is equal to product of mean, that is 8x is equal to 12 into 12. This implies x is equal to 12 into 12 upon 8. 4 to the 8, 4 to the 12, 2 to the 12, that is 16. Hence, third proportional be 18. Okay? You note it? The second part and third part, you will do that as well as same method. Now the second and third part of this question, you will do that as well as same method. Now we come on the next question, that is question number 10. If the third proportional of 7 and x is 28, that is 10. If third proportional 7 and x is 28. So 7 ratio x such that x ratio 28, that is equal to x into x is equal to 7 into 28. This implies x square is equal to 7 into 28. This implies x is equal to under root 7 into 7 into 2 into 2. 7 to the 40 to the 28, that is 7 into 2. This is x is equal to 40. Okay? So you note it. Find the mean proportional between We have discussed in our previous classes what will be the mean proportional. You know, if ABC, we know if ABC are continuous proportion, then So, x square is equal to 6 into 24. This implies x square is equal to 6 into 24. This implies x is equal to under root 6 into 24. That is under root 6 into 6 into 2 into 2. This is equal to 6 into 2. This implies x is equal to 12. Hence, mean proportional be 12. Okay? You note it. Okay, there are two part of more than question number 11. We will do that with the help of this question. Now we come on the next question. In the next question, what number must be added to each of the number added to 5, 9, 7, 12. To get the number which are in proportion. That is 5 plus x ratio 9 plus x as well as 7 plus x ratio 12 plus x. Now product of mean is equal to product of extreme. Product of extreme. Product of mean that is 5 plus x 12 plus x is equal to 9 plus x into 7 plus x, which give the 5 to the 60 plus 5x, x to the 12x plus x square, 9 to the 63 plus 9x plus 7x plus x square. X square is cancelled by x square, where 5x and 12x, that is 17x, 9x and plus 7x, that is 16x. That is 17x minus 16x is equal to 63 minus 16. So x is equal to 3. Hence we add 3 to get the number in proportion. Yeah, the given question, what number we add in the given number to get in the proportion? Let we add in the x. So when we add it in the x, then number will be 5x, 5 plus x, 9 plus x, 7 plus x and 12 plus x. Now it is in the proportion. Now this number is in the proportion. So 5 plus x ratio 9 plus x, such that 7 plus x ratio 12 plus x. Now by the product of extreme and product of mean, we will find that 5 plus x into 12 plus x is equal to 9 plus x into 7 plus x. When we multiply 60 plus 5x plus 12x plus x square, 63 plus 9x plus 7x plus x square. Now x square and both sides, that is same sign, so it will cancel. Now 5x and 12, that is 17x, and 9x plus 7x, that is 16x. When we transport the 16x, that is 17x minus 16, and 63 minus 60, that is x is equal to 3. When you can check the answer, 5 plus 3, that is 8.
8 upon 12, that is 10 upon 15. That is same.
So your answer is right.
Note it.
Okay. Now, question number 13, that is SN, there will be subtraction. So, you will suppose that let me subtract x to make it a proportion. Then you make the proportion and find the value of x. Okay. In the question number 13, that are same as well as question number 20, in that question you will subtract. So you suppose that let we subtract x from the given number to get it as a proportion, then we subtract here the addition, then in that question you will subtract that. Okay. Now we come on the question number 14. In the question number 14, the scale may be is 1:50. What is the actual distance between two towns if they are 4 cm apart the map?
Let the actual distance between two towns be x,
then
that is 14. Ratio of map distance is 1:500.
There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Right?
And
distance is my centimeter, that will convert in meter,
you will divide by 100, again you convert in a kilometer, that is equal to 200 kilometer. Okay, note it. Okay. Now, in the last question of your exercise, at a certain time, a tree 6 meter height cast a shadow of length 8 meter.
Yeah. Length of tree 6 meters. Shadow length of B
and length of pole. At the same time, a pole cast shadow length 20 meters.
Length of shadow of pole and 20 meters. Now, length of pole leg x meter.
Now, the length of tree, ratio of length of tree and shadow of tree will be equal to the ratio of length of pole and shadow of pole.
Now, x ratio 20 as well as same ratio 6:8.
Ratio of length of pole and their shadow is equal to ratio of tree and their shadow.
So that is equal to 8x is equal to 20 into 6. X is equal to 20 into 6 upon 8. That is 4 to the 8, 4 by the 20. That is 15 meters. Hence, the length of pole, that is 15 meters.
Okay. So, student, in today's class, we had completed the exercise 8B. There are one more exercise in given in chapter 8. That is the objective question. We will do that. If you have any problem, then you ask me. Okay, thank you. In your next class, we will discuss on a new chapter. Okay, thank you. Good day.